correct something Tobago has sought for 123 years, and a commitment made by the People's Partnership Government, self-government for Tobago. And if the Constitution Amendment Bill 2013 is passed, it will confer greater power to the people of Tobago. It will give the THA autonomy to borrow money for projects on the island. It will also allow for a fixed budgetary allocation from central government. But the most significant change is the autonomy to create its own laws.
To this end, Mr. Speaker, the powers of the Parliament of Trinidad and Tobago will henceforth be curtailed in relation to Tobago. In other words, there would be a devolution of legislative powers, albeit limited to the matters specified from this Parliament to the Tobago House of Assembly.
As she presented the legislation in the lower house today, Prime Minister Kamla Prasad Basesa says that for years Tobago has been subservient to Trinidad, and its disposition as the lesser of the two in the union was perpetuated by successive PNM regimes. Despite her criticism, she concedes that the legislation needs the support of the opposition PNM, since it requires a three-fourths majority in the lower house and two-thirds support in the Senate.
It will therefore require the support of opposition members of Parliament, and so I therefore wish to invite my friends on the other side to join with us in righting the wrongs of the past and to bestow full autonomy and dignity to the people of Tobago.
Among other changes that the bill will bring into force is the guarantee of 6.9% to 8% of the total national budget.
For the first time ever, Tobago will have a constitutional guarantee for its budgetary allocation.
Debate on the bill begins on January 16th. It has been criticized as being an election tactic ahead of the January 21st THA election. But the Prime Minister assures that the bill will not be rushed. Following parliamentary debate, the bill will be sent to a joint select committee for further deliberation.